Hello everyone, today I want to talk about another indicator called Intraday Momentum Index. The Intraday Momentum Index, or IMI, is an indicator that combines candlestick analysis and RSI. IMI looks at the relationship between the open and close prices over the course of the day, and not only how the open close price varies between days. So it looks at the end of the day prices. The main use of this indicator is to figure out when a price, when a market is overbought or oversold. I've already added the indicator to the chart. You can see here. But if you want to add, you go just to studies. If you're using ETAR or Pro Charts, then you can go study one and intraday momentum index, choose different colors, even change the overbought or oversold limits. Some people, you know, use different limits, for example 20 and 80s, or you know, whatever. So you can change that or even change the period. I left the preset numbers and keys and just change the colors for oversold and overbought, so I'm not adding that again. Okay, this indicator is very easy to use, and you know, for assets or markets like Bitcoin, for example, you want to buy at oversold position, you know, situations. So this is a very famous strategy actually between cryptocurrency traders. They just keep adding the oversold positions until they get to a certain number, then they sell their positions and wait for more dips to buy more. So by the look at the indicator, you can see the buy signals are when we are in oversold area, and it's best to, you know, wait for the time that the indicator goes just above the 30 or 20 or oversold line, then you put the buy. For example, let me add a line here. So if I add a vertical line here, when we get the signal, you can see we have the signal here and price keeps going up. Okay, then it's up to you if you decide that which of these overbought positions you can close your buy positions. And as you go here, you can see another dip here, and you can buy more, buy here, buy here. Then when it goes to one of the overbought situations, sorry, you can close your buy Bitcoin positions. And this is how to use it on the cryptocurrency, but you can use it on any other markets. For example, let me put Dow Jones here. As you can see, again, we have the buy signals. For example, here we have a buy signal, then it goes up. But you know, for indexes, sell signals are very, very tricky, so you may put a very close trailing stop loss maybe when you open the sell position. But for the buy positions, you are more you have more confidence in your position that it's gonna turn green anyway in long term. But you know, even in big collapses like the one that we had in February and March, this indicator gives you some false signals as well. For example, here you can see it gives us a buy signal, but again, after a few days, it dropped significantly. So we all remember this, and we all remember the pain that we had during this time. So I would say look at your ATR numbers or other volatility indicators. Then don't use this indicator if you are working on indexes or even currencies during the volatile markets. For crypto, again, you know, that's buy, keep, hold positions are gonna work in long term anyway, and you're not paying any fees on that, so that may work still over there. But for indexes, just stay away when it's volatile and don't use this IMI indicator. That was all about this indicator. If you have any questions, just leave me a comment and you can contact me. I'm happy to answer your questions. Have a nice day. See you later.